Ito kasabihan po ito na ang dami ko ng beses narinig. The idle mind is the workshop of the devil. Pag wala kang ginagawa sa absolute na katamaran mo, anong mangyayari? Lalo kang mas malapit sa tukso. Dahil mapaglalaruan ng demonyo ang utak na hindi gumagana, ang katawan na walang ginagawa. Hello mga ka-RFF, this is again Rex Mendoza from Ramber Financials. I hope you and all your loved ones are healthy and okay. We're commemorating Holy Week in the midst of another strict lockdown. And this is the reason why I felt this topic was relevant. This week, we remember the ultimate sacrifice that our Lord and Savior has done for us, to die on the cross to save us from our sins. And speaking of sins, that's ultimately the topic I'd want to discuss. Tama po yan. Mga kasalanan. Seven deadly sins. Seven capital sins. Ito po ay hango sa Christian theology. Wala po sa Bible. But the ethical guidelines have set things up to define what we call capital sins. Sa Latin po, yung capital is caput, which means the head. And obviously, the head controlling the body. So what do they mean by that? The seven capital or cardinal sins, or the seven deadly sins, are ultimately the source of other sins. The vice that actually leads to other vices. And syempre po, financial literacy pa din ang puntirya natin sa channel na ito. I would like to be able to connect and use the seven capital sins as a metaphor also in investing. So there is a parallel. But first, a real caveat, I don't want to do this because I'm actually a righteous person. I think we all know that we are great sinners. And understanding these sins might help us in avoiding them. Kahit papano po, magbibigay ako ng konting advice. Some advice that I'd also want to listen to and adhere to myself. But much like many of you, I struggle on a daily basis. And I think that's the reality that we will have to contend with. These are the sins that we commit, and hopefully awareness will lead us to somehow get to avoid doing them in the future. So umpisahan po natin. Ano yung sinasabi nila na unang-una at pinakamabigat na deadly capital sin? And that is pride. Alam niyo yung pride is the original and most serious kasi ito daw talaga halos pinaghahanguan ng karamihan na ibang kasalanan. They sometimes refer to this as hubris or futility. It's an excessive view of oneself. Parang lagi kang nauuna, parang ikaw lagi ang importante. It's dangerous, corrupt selfishness. You know, when you think you're better than others, you're more important, and you're far superior. Mabigat daw po ang deadly sin na ito. So, anong solution at anong katapat? Cardinal virtues. And the cardinal virtue that matches up with pride is humility. Is to be humble and modest. Sabi nga ni Jesus, di ba? Who is first will be last, and who is last will be first. Kahit papano po kailangan isipin natin. Hindi naman tayo magiging successful. Hindi naman tayo magiging achiever if not for the help, assistance, and maybe mentorship of others. So let us acknowledge people who have blessed us in our lives. Let us take the fact that we are where we are because other people helped us. Now, ano naman po ang counterpart nito sa investing? Ang counterpart nito sa investing, you know, pride in investing means holding on to an investment even if there is no recovery in sight. Many of us actually make mistakes Pero dahil ma-pride tayo, ayaw nating bitawan, ayaw nating aminin na nagkamali tayo. So if we're going to be guilty of pride, we're going to be punished with all the bad things it brings. So ano pong solution sa field of investing? Dapat po is to be humble, is to admit that we actually make mistakes. Admit that we make mistakes and do rectification or remedial action. Kailangan po, kung talagang mali, mag-cut losses tayo. You know, we cannot be right all the time. Kailangan po aminin natin na talagang nagkakamali tayo. And when we make wrong investments, we have to be humble enough to step back and undo what we have done. See, sometimes, itong pride na ito na akala mo lagi kang kailangan maging tama all the time, that's where it's coming from eh. Na parang kahit alam mong mali na yung ginawa mo, parang paninindigan mo pa siya dahil gusto mo siyang gawing tama para yung batting average mo maganda. You know, when we make mistakes. And we have to rectify and correct them. The next sin is greed. Ano naman po yung greed? Greed is a deep desire for material possessions. It is covetousness. It's actually forgetting God and worshiping material things. Pag mas importante na po ang mga material na bagay, nagiging ganid tayo. So anong correction sa greed? Ang correction sa greed is charity. When we give and give generously to others. So nasusolusyonan po yung ating desire to accumulate all of these possessions by beginning to share them. Kailangan din po, we have to understand that we should be a blessing to others and that we cannot take anything with us. Lagi ko pong paulit-ulit na sinasabi ito, wala pa akong nakikitang kabaong na may baggage compartment. Wala kayong madadala dyan. Since wala tayong madadala dyan, ang kailangan natin gawin, we have to share it, not just with our loved ones, but to other people who need the help. And how does greed manifest in investing? You know, sa investments naman, ang nangyayari, di ba? Kumikita na, parang gustong sumobra pang laki ng kita. You know, you're investing to reach goals. Holding up for the next level profit sometimes can also be wrong. Since you're investing for goals, and you're achieving goals, we don't always have to go for that triple bagger, that five bagger, and all that stuff. It's very important that we maintain a good, solid strategy, and we go back to the ultimate purpose of investing, which is to achieve goals. The next capital sin is lust. Ito namang lust is intense carnal longing, yung unbridled and uncontrollable desire for sex, money, and power. And ang sagot po sa sin of lust is the cardinal virtue of chastity. It's abstinence. It's trying to move into what we call the purity of thought and actions. Kaya po minsan, napaka-importante din ang Holy Week. Dahil dito sa Holy Week natin talaga na ma-manifest ang pag-iwas natin sa mga masasamang bagay na ito. We have to try to be in control. And if we cannot, the best move is actually to avoid the temptation. It's not to be in situations where we cannot control ourselves. How about in investing? Can lust happen in investments? And the answer is yes. You know, you let emotions direct your investment decisions. When you miss out on the objectivity, when you miss out on time-tested rules of strategy, so para na kayong engulfed ng inyong emotions, masyado na kayong attached at masyado na kayong nagiging slave to the emotions that are directed by what's happening to your investments. So what's the solution to that? Lust in investing. It's minimizing the sentiment. It's trying to get down into fundamental analysis and to check what's really logical, what is really factual. You seek rational basis for your decisions. You tend to eliminate that emotion. And this is one of the reasons why I say yung mga chief financial officers ng mga kumpanya, they always do better for the money of their companies but not their own money. Because the money of their companies is what? Is not their money. So they're not emotionally attached. When we are emotionally attached to our investing, there is a bigger probability we will be making more mistakes in our investment decisions. The next capital sin is envy. And yes, it is deadly. It is the strong desire to have something that somebody else possesses. Diba yung parang ang gusto mo yung meron ng iba? Hindi kung ano ang meron ka. Envy is a source of unhappiness and discontent. Ito po obvious na obvious nangyayari sa atin. It is when we have something and we're happy with it, then all of a sudden, makikita natin sa iba, mas maganda, mas malaki, mas marami. And guess what? Maiinggit tayo at gusto rin natin kung ano ang meron nila. And that's the reason why mahirap maging kontento. Mahirap maging masaya. Dahil nagkakaroon ka ng dahilan para mainggit ka sa iba. So anong katapat ng envy? What's the cardinal virtue that matches up with envy? It is kindness. Kindness is being satisfied with what you have and having a mindset of not possessing but sharing. If you're kind, you're focused on sharing it with others, which means you are not going to be there wanting. Hindi mo nakikita ang kulang, nakikita mo yung abundance. And how is envy manifested in investing? Diba? Pag may kumikita, gusto mo mas malaking kita mo. Pag mayroong nagsabi na ito ang kanilang rate of return, gusto mo mas mataas ka din doon. Pag nagsabi silang ganitong kalaki ang kanilang portfolio, dapat mas malaki yung sayo. You know, we all have our own goals and we all have our own personal financial journey. You have to focus on your journey. You're not supposed to look at the journey of others. And if you hit your goals within your track, then you have to be happy and content with it. Adjust your goals upward. But you're not comparing yourself with others. You're comparing yourself with what you can do. And if you can do better, then that's great. Hindi inggit sa iba. You actually have your own standard. And if you increase that level or standard, well and good for you. Be an objective investor. Focus on your own goals and the achievement of those goals. The next capital sin is gluttony. Gluttony is overindulgence. Walang satisfaction. Overconsumption to the point of waste. Diba? Walang kabusugan, talagang kontodo lamon. Not sharing with the needy and the hungry. Ano po ang cardinal virtue na katapat ng gluttony? It's temperance. It's the aspiration for moderation. Yung pong tama lang. Hindi kailangan sobra. Alam nyo, anything that's too much can actually be bad. Even the best things, when there's too much of them, they can be bad. So we will have to aspire for moderation. We will have to be able to restrain ourselves. Maybe sometimes the question we need to ask is this: when is enough enough? Sometimes man's aspiration to have more and more will lead them to do worse things. So how is gluttony manifested in investing? It is when you throw risk out the window. It's when you try to aspire to earn more and more and more, that there's even no benchmark anymore. You just want to grow and grow your portfolio. In fact, this is when you put all of your eggs in one basket and not being cognizant of all the risks that you're getting into. All because you want absolutely bigger and bigger level of returns. Wala ka ng kabusugan din sa kinikita mo, you are never gonna be satisfied with what you're earning. So how do you correct this? You correct gluttony in investing by being cognizant of your risk appetite. and matching an investment portfolio that is aligned with that risk appetite. It also dictates that you have diversification, that you have the correct asset allocation, and making sure that you don't have too much on a particular position or investment. The next capital sin is wrath. Wrath is extreme anger. It's hate. It's rage towards some other person. When we don't control wrath, it leads us to violence and to feuds. Alam niyo yung mga away na mga pamilya that even extends to generations. That is wrath. And at a certain point, you know, that tendency to wish and seek vengeance is part of wrath. So ano pong katapat ng wrath? Anong cardinal virtue? Is patience. Let us be patient with other people. Let us try to forgive. Alam nyo, one of the toughest is to be compassionate, to understand where some other person is coming from. To be merciful and to forgive actually benefits us, not the other person. We ease ourselves of the burden if we forgive others and we take the anger out of our system. How is wrath manifested in investing? Abi, nangyayari po sa atin yan, yung absolutely magagalit ka. Kasi if your investments are not performing up to expectations, when you're getting too impatient, you know, sometimes your strategy requires a bit of time. And I tell a lot of people this, kahit ano namang gawin natin, pagsigaw, kahit ano namang gawin natin, pagkagalit, we cannot change the direction of the market. The way to address a market and volatile market movements is to have the right strategy to adhere to, whether it's working over the short term or not. Because we have to be patient on how things get to unfold. We will have to control our emotions and patience. Patience is always that virtue. Let the strategy unfold. Give your investments the time to bear fruit and to give you the fulfillment of your goals. The last cardinal sin, the last deadly sin, is sloth. Sloth is when you have excessive laziness, absence of interest. Alam nyo, kasalanan din talaga yung walang ginagawa. Kasalanan din talaga yung, you know, you're not using or utilizing the talent that our Creator has given you. You know, this failure to act is also a sin. And this is something that's real. Ito, kasabihan po ito na ang dami ko ng beses narinig. The idle mind is the workshop of the devil. Pag wala kang ginagawa sa absolute na katamaran mo, anong mangyayari? Lalo kang mas malapit sa tukso. Dahil mapaglalaruan ng demonyo ang utak na hindi gumagana, ang katawan na walang ginagawa. So, again, the cardinal virtue that matches up with sloth is diligence. Diligence is the pursuit of making a difference to our loved ones and to society as a whole. Alam nyo, as people, we have this duty to contribute to our world, to that environment around us. We have to have that aspiration of growth and that pursuit of service to our fellow man. So how is sloth in investing? It is when there is also laziness, not taking responsibility and accountability for our financial track. It's not studying and understanding how money works and how our future is actually at risk if we don't do anything about it. So the solution is to take an active role in financial planning. It is to regularly review and refine goals, because the achievement of goals is our personal duty and accountability. And again, very important, not just to ourselves, but to our family and loved ones. Most importantly, to society as a whole. Kasi contributory po tayo sa ganda ng ating mundo at sa ganda ng ating environment. I hope this short discussion of the 7 deadly capital sins will be helpful for you. Probably will lead you to ponder within this week how they manifest in our lives and how we can correct them as we move towards the next weeks and months of 2021. And I also hope that it can highlight our financial responsibility and accountability to make sure that we manage ourselves within our financial track. We will appreciate it if you will give us a like. And for those of you who are new, please do subscribe and hit the bell button so that you will be notified of our up and coming videos. Again, this is Rex Mendoza wishing all of you a blessed Holy Week. Thank you and God bless always.